the junkyard. I mean, this car was kind of picked over. I mean, there's not really much left of the body panel. I mean, most of the stuff's just rusted out. But we'll hopefully get it, you know, looking a little bit better. But that's all I got for it. So this will be a time lapse, and I will see you at the end.
We'll be right back. Thank you. Yeah, she might be pretty, but I promise it gets scary. When she wants your daddy and she finds out where you live, creeping in the shadows, eating poisoned apples. She's nothing like you ever seen. Her mood goes up and down and round and round, and ain't no telling what she might do next. Cause she's an itty bitty spider with an itty bitty ladder, and she might just come for you. Should always sleep with one eye open. You better keep in mind to always look over your shoulder. Cause when you think you're safe, just stay awake. She's moving closer. Cause she's an itty bitty spider with an itty bitty ladder, and she might just come for you.
What type of paint job we can get here? Thinking of one of the Fast and Furious cars is what this reminds me of. The livery that's on it. Might try to get that same livery, and then yeah, it looks pretty good. And then try to match the blue as close as I can. Maybe whatever the stock colors might be. But I had to paint for that so I could save at least the legendary portion. And then go back through and that kind of actually looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and paint that, get that all painted. It does look nice. So, gotta admit, it looks pretty good. I'd say it's about the same blue. Maybe a little tinge lighter in some areas, but you know, I did what I could. I just get to go to the dyno it. Maybe we try to make a little bit more horsepower than it did when it came from the factory. This is just going to take me a minute to figure out how I want to tune it and how much I want to get out of it. I try to get the maximum that I can out of it, but it takes me a while to figure that part out. Okay, I can go here and get this, you know. I try to usually get, like, the highest, whatever the highest amount is. Some of it might be different, you know. Not about as high as I think I could get it. So, I mean, it did take me a while to figure out, you know, where I wanted it. So.
Are you scared?
It did. What I should do. Now we get to mess with the... I just tried to cut down on some of the final drive ratio a little bit. Basically just trying to make it not super quick, but you know, shave it down a little bit while giving it the most chance of actually working. Well, I didn't forget sneaking clips. That's it. I mean, if that's the only thing I, you know, forgot, then I don't feel too bad. But this thing had two of them, so I only missed one of them, so it's not too terribly bad. So, I thought that I did it, you know, with, you know, having both sides clear. I probably thought one of them was done, and then I looked over on that one. But I thought I did that one, to be honest. There's too much difference in between them. Like, I can't. When you do one side of a car, right, that has another, you know, air inlet box, like this one where it had a dual, I thought I built both of them. It's alright though, I'll get these stinking clips installed. Like, I think, honestly, that's probably what it was. I thought I built it, but I didn't, because I built the one side. That might be what it is, but I don't know, it's hard for me to, like, say, oh, well, I did it. No, it wasn't. I thought I did. But I guess, yeah, they kind of look identical. That's what kind of really messes me up sometimes. But, to each their own. But I honestly thought that I had that installed, but apparently I didn't. I didn't even double check it because I thought I did it, but oh well. I just forgot to install, you know, half the airbox. Nah, it'll be fine. I'm surprised that even, you know, wanted to try to start at that point. But no. Ooh. She's got a lot of horsepower behind her now. Definitely has more than the stock had. That was my whole plan anyway. Just trying to get a little bit more than the stock came with. But this one might be a little too fast for me. Who knows? I mean, I could, you know, easily do it, but I think I'm gonna get a couple pictures up before I go ahead and take it out of the truck. And that way, if I damage it, I still have a picture of the truck with me, and try for my home too. You built it once, you can build it again, man. Honestly, if you have this car going, like, some of the speeds that I have seen these, like, faster cars go, it's like you would need too much takeoff speed because you could probably take off and land. This one's doing pretty good. This one might. It's going. Going pretty quick, but I think we're going to start running out of interstate here. Yep. Oof. A little bounce off the wall never hit anything, right? Alright, let's see if we can get another run at it. If not, we'll just take it back to the shop and sell it so I don't, you know, hurt anything. Well, it's a little bit of a rolling start because you gotta think. Car when we first tried it was stationary. But instead it just looks, you know, it's kinda pulling pretty hard though. It wants me to go into the ditch. I don't want to though. I'm trying not to, but I don't think we'll ever get another good solid line of it before. I don't think so, because you know, we got it set up pretty good in that first one. That first run, I think, was pretty good. The second one, I don't know if you would have been able to save it or not. It was just kind of like that rear end, just wanted to keep sliding. Slide right out from underneath you. You stay one spot, and the rear end stays in the other. That's pretty much what she was trying to do. But I hope that doesn't actually happen. Let's see, how much are we going to get for it? Yeah, that's a lot. That was a lot. I will see you on the next one. Take a moment right here. Feeling like it's out of gear.